Shatta Wale came to me, I prayed for him. We had the privilege of traveling on the same flight from Accra to London. He was carrying my bags and everything, and I prayed for him, and I said he was not going to die. I got bashing from a lady who was a priestess or a fetish priest at that time, or that, whatever.
Okay, yeah, I am on Ghana TV. Ever since for Reverend Dr. Lawrence Tetteh Akasa, Afa Shatta Wale and Seminole. Wasi Wale, eye ne ba, eye ne yase ya chene diye, nen so, eye, ebe ma omu, eye omu se omu bro mrano sono, omu e suya diye, afe enso so, IGP dampari, wabwe juma pa, na semwe, ebi baye, ema mribi, ono sube kan Shatta Wale diye sa, ama obo mpaye mano, enko fo chana da pa, kama, prophecies ni diye, eye no kure, e woho, nen so se diye free titing na, ye wo fake prophet woho no, e jume biya, ebi wom, en sentwe juma, ye wo fake wom, sa anso no, doctors, ye wo fake wom, ti e wo be biya, enti no, the real prophets ni musi ka mo ho asam ni ade no mo to mbo ase wi sey enko na enko tie no somra.
I think that we are not properly informed and educated. People become very little minded and they lose focus of who they are and what values are. 3 years ago I was caught up in this when Shatta Wale had a prophecy from somebody that he was going to die in December. Shatta Wale came to me, I prayed for him. We had the privilege of traveling on the same flight from Accra to London. He was carrying my bags and everything, and I prayed for him. And I said he was not going to die. And I also advised him that a statement he made about going to burn churches if the prophet doesn't come true is not right. And that two mistakes doesn't make it correct. I believe that sometimes we don't hate the people who hate us. And I keep saying that in our silence, we make volumes of statement and we make noise. So I advised Shatta Wale and I went out to make a statement that it will not trend. If you really follow that time, I got bashing from a lady who was a priestess or a fetish priest at that time, or that, whatever. And I didn't respond. But I think that from that we should be learning. Most of our musicians and our artists are not properly counseled, and I think it's very unfortunate because Shatta Wale doesn't need this situation at all to be popular. By the grace of God, he's trended, he's been accepted, he has his place in the domain in our community. So I think some of these things need counseling, and I'm happy with the trend things are taking. I think I must commend IGP George Dampare. He's doing very well. Some of these things, except that we must be very circumcised and be balanced. It must be for all. It must cut off. It should not be done for one other person and not be done to another person.
This the pastor who is also in the custody of the police, people like him, don't they give men of the cloth a bad name with all these prophecies in public? If you have seen something about somebody that is negative, the argument is why not tell a person quietly? Why go to a media platform and blast this thing out? Aren't they making you look bad?
That is what I'm saying. That in fact, many people make people look bad. To be honest with you, a lot of journalists make journalists look bad. A lot of lawyers make lawyers look bad. A lot of doctors make doctors look bad. So that one is something. So human nature. In every community, you have the good, the bad, and the ugly.
Then let me flip it around. Why are Ghanaians so consumed with prophecies? Ghanaian Christians, why are they so consumed? Somebody says something and then you're so quick to believe it.
The truth is that the percentage of people who get carried away with those things are very minute. You know what makes this thing popular? Social media. And it's the press, the media, that makes some of this thing trend. Some of the things that we hear are things that should not fly in other places. But because we become little-minded and very inquisitive-minded, we want to hear, aka, aka, yese, yese, and that's what. But hear me. Prophecies are true and real. As a Muslim sheikh, he will tell you it is true. As a pastor, I will tell you it is true. Except that the problem we have is that we seem to be abusing everything. And we undermine the very credibility of this great gift of prophecy. We must educate the people. And what I'm saying is that the law is the law. If you prophesy, it doesn't come true. You know, in the olden days, if you give a prophecy, it doesn't come true. You are stoned to death.
You want to come back?
Today, people can stand anywhere and go and give a prophecy and get away with murder. And whether it comes true, it doesn't come true. But you know what? People are fizzling out. People are being realized. The truth is being seen. At the end of the day, you and I, will not call names, but we know who are true prophets and who are not true prophets. And for me, that is the most important thing. You know when somebody says this is going to happen or this should have happened, and then you realize that you look from between the line. Don't we even have prophets today who prophesy in the name of politics? And then you can tell, you sit back and you realize that if this is what the prophecy is all about, then you go and sleep. And so we are getting there where gradually Ghanaians are becoming very discerning, and very soon certain people, I don't want to give this reference, but remember what happened to Apreku, my daughter. It's a very sad situation, and something I don't want to be referring to, but he was given a prophecy, was supposed to have come from God. And then they asked him, what did God say, Apreku, my daughter? It means God didn't know the difference between daughter and son. This was how they do that. And so at the end of the day, you cannot impress people. You cannot impress the people of God. God himself has his way of protecting people. And so some of these things, I keep saying that we should not just be at the doorstep of the churches. There are a lot of lawyers who are not correct. There are a lot of journalists who are not correct. They are not in the Bible. From Quran and Bible time today, we've had fake prophets. We have false prophets. And so we still have them. We just have to wisen up and have knowledge for ourselves, understanding for ourselves, so that we will not be swayed by things. But these things are bound to happen. It's a human nature. Don't you have politicians who, when they say good morning, you have to look at your watch? We do. Don't you have journalists that you expect them to know better, and yet they do things, and you wonder that with all the pedigree of this gentleman, he should not be doing this. So by all means, we'll have that. We just have to pray and inform ourselves and make sure that we create an awareness so we all not be swayed into this manner. It's very unfortunate. I feel very sad for Shatta Wale. There is somebody who calls me daddy and refers to me, and you expect him to know better. And he's a fine young man. So he should wake up. Maybe this is a wake-up call to all of us, that the law is no respecter of persons. And that if we continue to do things like that, we don't just undermine our own credibility. We undermine the credibility of the vocation in which we are.
Okay, I'm here for Reverend Dr. Lawrence Tetteh, and I call her and I watch him. Was I pray who my daughter cry? No, no, if you are sanity, or no, do maybe a shame compa, and so we are here. It's we are sitting here, young coupon, and a name dear warrior. Mess us also do a gentry, a beba, no subscribe to One Ghana TV. Esika for gentleman capsules, a ye drobi a bema, so no more bits make now, so no boy juma, full nente. Ẹnu ti bẹma bọ mọden ne kopẹ binum sanso na antie si capsules se de e ma ne yage atum ya so mu se twetwe bo so me so a onte se e gbobena bia bia sanso na ma ya hifie ho eye krogen me pa cho se ye antie si capsules se ye esikafo gentleman capsules so pe bi e wo online ato a ubenye bi wo amazon.co.uk amazon.co.uk bọ mọden ne kopẹ bi eto sanso na tap tap send eye mobile money app a ye de send sika from Europe to Ghana me pa cho wo Canada o America de ohia ne se obe download the tap tap send e wo phone so na wo download the process no ye bebusa promo code me patcho ya bo one Ghana she ho na tap tap send for se ye busa promo code na bo one Ghana na wo Canada o America $10 e ye wo dia sanso na wo Europe £5 and now 5 euros ye de chew free woni ma negi se ma ewo wa download ya wie na wo send sika no ebusua charges bi anim ye ntu bi bia o mpe we na opade tap tap send. What's the papa no no? Me patch social media baby, TikTok, Instagram, media me deho ye ama pokia numunjaba.
Me did the young antechua, and maybe I'm discovered for Europe, I come busy for Ghana no. Me used to tap tap send. Tap tap send. No fee mobile money transfer. E ye easy, e ye convenient, e ye fast, and sounds so ye free. Woo to ya she. Me discover ye ma pim. Tap tap send. Intienne, once you download the Tap Tap Send app, no, ever mobile phone so free. Let first see how come we're boosting your forward Ghana for na. Tap Tap Send, Papa no.